Will Parks, the Eagles' new defensive back, is going to join us here in just a couple of moments on the Boardwalk Hotline. As, NFL free agency continues to move on. Will Parks, one of the many free agents that the Eagles have added, but they've all been on the defensive side of the ball. And it seems that that has been the message today. Howie Roseman spoke for 50 minutes, a video conference call with Eagles beat writers. And he talked about Will Parks, and we will talk to Will right now on the Boardwalk Honda Hotline, a Philly guy. He is coming back to Philly. He's kind enough to join us now here on the Sports Bash. Will, welcome home, man. How you been?
What's up, guys, man? How we doing? I've been good. How about yourself?
We are doing well. We're doing the show in a bunch of different spots. So I'm at home. My co-host is at home. My producer's back at the studio. So we're all trying to stay safe, but through the power of technology, we've got you on the show. And I look forward to it, man. I'm very intrigued. We talked to Nick Ferguson out in Denver earlier this week, and he had a lot of glowing things to say about you. And he kind of indicate that, hey, people aren't giving Will Parks enough credit for what he brought to that Denver team. And I wonder, like, is that the kind of, you know, you're a Philly guy, so you probably have that, you know, that Philly attitude to begin with. But do you feel the same way that, hey, not enough people know who Will Parks is and are about to find out?
That's exactly how I feel, brother. I think that's a good feeling to have, you know what I mean, just to have. I always had a chip on my shoulder. I've always been one of those guys who's been, like, you know, underrated and things of that sort. But that's okay because, you know, I love going out there and proving people wrong and making plays and making sure that my team wins games. So as long as that's the motive and that's the focal point is winning games and doing the things the right way, then I'm fine with what people say.
Yeah, one of the things he mentioned was, you know, you had Simmons out there and you had some high draft picks in front of you, and yet you were still found a way to get a role as a six-round pick, and it kind of is a testament to what you bring to the table. But my question for you is, where is it that you feel most comfortable? Because it's being billed that, well, Will Parks can play corner and he can play safety. Where do you prefer?
Everywhere you just mentioned, outside, up top, in the middle, on three, and the A-gap and the B-gap as a non-technique inside of the A-gap, you know, so wherever I'm best suitable for that week or that matchup, wherever it is Jim Schwartz want me to do, this upcoming year, I'm all for it. I'm up for the challenge. I want the hard down on me, stuff like that. So I'm excited to showcase my talents here for the city.
Now, some of the film that I watched of you was eye-opening to see you come up and stop the run, bringing down guys like Derrick Henry, making tackles on these big running backs. So it seems like you're a guy who's not afraid to get up and mix it up in the box either.
I'm from North Philly. We're not afraid of nothing. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and I'm out there on the field and I'm hitting people and I'm doing all those types of things, man. I'm just fearless with the fact that, you know, it was always once harder than being out there. It already was. So to take on those responsibilities is just a testament to those coaches putting me in that A-gap and ensuring that I can get the job done. So it's pretty amazing to go out there against those big guys. I enjoy that.
Will, you tweeted out the other day, you had me laughing. You said, man, just talk to Coach Peterson. It's lit. He's lit. He's listening to Post Malone. Would you have pegged Coach Peterson for a Post Malone guy, number one? And how excited are you to play for him?
Yeah, I'm not even going to lie. Once you said Post Malone, it all made sense. So I was excited when I called him and we had a conversation. He just mentioned that, you know what I mean? That's just like all he had to tell me was that he was listening to Post Malone, and that just tells you that, you know, that guy's up to date on everything that's going on in the world right now. He's a player coach. He cares about his team, cares about winning, cares about working hard, doing the right thing. So that was definitely awesome to have a conversation with that guy, and I can't wait to go to work for him.
Will, what's something that the fans don't know about you? So a fun fact. Who's Will Parks off the field? You know, tell us a little bit about the man, Will Parks, besides in between the lines.
I'm a big, community activist, you know what I mean? I don't even want to say community activist, and I don't want to tell y'all that because I don't expect any awards for doing the right thing for my people. I don't expect any, you know, accolades as far as, like, giving back to community. This is truly what I desire to do each and every day. As far as helping out kids that look up to me, kids that look at the other people around me, people who can't eat every day, I try to provide for them. My whole family, my mom, she's trying to build a mom mentorship program for moms who struggle and single that raise kids, especially young boys. So, you know, that's basically me, man. And I love to go paintballing, you know what I mean? At Crusaders Paintball up there in Lehigh Valley. So I like to do a lot of things off the field, man.
We're talking with Will Parks, the new Eagles defensive back, do-it-all Swiss Army knife, versatile player. Let me ask you, how difficult was this free agent process with what's going on? Like, I guess it had to be a little different than what it would have been had we been able to travel freely and meet face to face.
Yeah, man, that definitely sucks. You know what I mean? It hindered and postponed and it stopped a lot of flow of a lot of things. But, it's a minor setback for a major comeback. I think, first off with the scientists and other leaders that we have leading the charge against, fighting this deadly virus, I think we have a great group of people out there that's taking charge of doing the right thing as far as overcoming this challenge. But, the ability to adapt, I just said it on the last show, the ability to adapt and overcome things and be able to do things still while things are hindered. Like for you guys to be on the show and to obviously still communicate with people, not being in the actual workplace, that speaks dividends to the passion that you guys have and everybody else, who have to do things differently in order to still work and continue to collect funds. So it's a challenge, but we'll get through it.
So other than Doug Peterson being a Post Malone fan, what was the selling point about this Eagles defense? I mean, Malcolm Jenkins walks out the door, and now they're looking for people to replace him. They get Slay. They've got you. They've got Hargrave. I mean, Jatavius Brown, Roby Coleman. They're obviously looking to change the Eagles are this defense, specifically that secondary, which has been just a bodies coming in and out over the last three seasons. The amount of injuries has been outrageous. But what was the message that sold you on that's the spot for me?
I think Howie being in communication with me the whole time throughout the free agency process, going over some film today with Tim Hop, keeping it real with me and helping me, this so fast, being able to just keep me updated on the playbook and be able to be on the phone with me for almost 2 hours, just talk plays and for Coach M and obviously Jim Schwartz, you know what I mean? Like me and Schwartz had a conversation before I made that commitment, and it felt like he already knew me, you know what I'm saying? So, when guys do a lot of research on you and they know who you are and they know the skills that you have, but in order for you to go somewhere and be able to trust them, it takes a big a jump. So, that's what basically sold me, man. It was just the people in the building and the fact that they want to win championships and they want to win now. I'm all for it.
Yeah, was there any, hey, we're looking for you to play this role, that role, all the roles? I mean, Malcolm played about 9 different positions, and he never missed a snap. So whoever has to fill those shoes is going to have a huge role, whether it be you, Mills, that's going to probably, get a chance to move to safety. I mean, was there any indication of this is the role we're picturing for you, Will Parks?
Yeah, man, just everywhere, you know what I mean? You said just being everywhere on defense, with Mills, and you got a lot of interchangeable guys back there. So I think on any given Sunday that, you can see guys in different roles. But, for me, that's what I pride myself on as far as just being able to move around and not being a sitting duck and making plays from all angles of the field and stuff like that. So that's definitely something I pride myself on and I look forward to here coming the next couple of months, weeks.
All right, we're talking with Eagles safety, defensive back, I guess, do-it-all, Will Parks with us, a Philly guy. Are you back home? Are you hanging out in Philly? You've been all over, man. Denver, you went to school where? Arizona, right?
Yeah, I went to Arizona. I went to University of Arizona for 4 years, and I got drafted to Denver 2016. But right now, I'm currently in Philly. I've been here for the past 2 off seasons. I train here. That's exactly why I'm here, because I train here, and I train in Texas as well. But, obviously, with the virus going on and stuff like that, I've just stayed here. But I've been here for like months at a time, so to be here and just be here with my family, it's all good, man.
All right. Well, it's a great signing. It's great to have you on board with us here in the Philly area, and obviously stay safe and please try to keep everybody healthy. This secondary has been just decimated by injuries over the years. And hopefully everybody stays healthy. And we appreciate you coming on board the show, Will, on a pretty weird time in our lives.
Nah, man, it's all good. One thing for sure, I tell you, everybody putting in work. I can tell you that. They putting in work now, so by the time we start to suit things up and get ready to rock and roll, man, we're going to be ready. We're going to be in shape. We're going to be ready to go.
Awesome stuff. Great to hear from Will Parks. We appreciate the time, Will. Thanks.
Man, appreciate you guys. Thank you.
Absolutely. New Eagle safety, corner, defensive back, do it all, play defensive tackle, play linebacker, play in the box, tackle you. He does it all. Will Parks there on the Sports Bash Live, 97.3 ESPN.